How should parents deal with a close and extended family regarding adoption and making the decision?
Well, first, it's important to distinguish between close family members and extended family. Now, close family, in all likelihood, is, you know, grandparents and aunts and uncles who either live nearby or are very much a part of, you know, the adoptive parents' lives. So, some conversation with them about the decision, not in order to make it, but in order to inform them that the decision has been made.
Okay.
But along with that, perhaps to understand what their concerns are, if they have any, their questions and their doubts, so that these can be legitimately and politely answered. Because, you know, people come from a variety of experiences about how adoption doesn't work out, how things could go wrong.
Okay.
So some level of reassurance and so on, particularly if the parents are expecting these people to be part of the support system for the child. After all, you want the child to have family. And to also have a positive conversation with them to say you're counting on them. You really want them to be a part of the child's life, how important they are. But also to be very clear in telling close family that there are no secrets in adoption, that you plan to be completely open with the child, and that you as parents will be doing the adoption disclosure to the child, not them.
Okay.
So these are some things to keep in mind about how we engage with the extended family, close family and relatives. You see, ultimately, no matter how close, they cannot be part of making the decision, because the child is yours, as in the child belongs to the adoptive parents. And having children, raising a child, as I said earlier, this is a deeply personal and individual choice made by the two people concerned, by the parents. And so how to engage with the extended family, how much to tell them, how much importance to give, that has to be agreed between the couple, between the parents. And that's how you move forward on it.